Our flag is the fourth oldest of all national standards of the world. Older than the Union Jack of Great Britain or the tricolor of France. On the following, August 3rd, it was first flown from Fort Sawyer, New York. At first, it was decided that there would be a star and a stripe for each state. But it soon became evident this new nation grew into a giant composed of many states. In 1818, Congress enacted a law decreeing the flag of the United States, 13 horizontal stripes, alternate red and white star to be added to the blue field upon the admission of each new state. The new star to be added on the 4th of July followed the admission of each new state. Our flag now has 50 stars representing the 50 states and 13 stripes representing the 13 original colonies. Our country was founded on a religious principle, and the proper folding of our flag demonstrates this wonderful truth.
Our third
third state is New Jersey. The fourth colony to ratify the Constitution was Georgia. As her strife has fitted into our pattern, let me remind you Old Glory was first carried in the battle at Brandywine, September 11, 1777. As the fifth strike takes its place, you will be interested to know that January 28, 1778, our flag flew over foreign territory at Nassau in the Bahama Islands. With Connecticut now in place, we recall it was the French Admiral Lamont Fink who gave our flag its first foreign salute, February 2, 1778. The sixth strike is the last one to be fully visible. The remaining seven are just as long, but part of each stripe is covered by the blue Union. Massachusetts takes her place as the immediate support of the blue field. The blue field you now see going in place takes its color from the heavens and reminds us to be reverent to God, to seek truth, fidelity, and justice in all our actions. The stars proclaim a new constellation and remind us again that we are one nation under God. The seventh stripe state is Maryland. Very proud to have the blue Union cover part of her stripe of battle. South Carolina is next, and a reminder that our flag symbolizes national independence and sovereignty. It is the flag of 210 million free people firmly united. To gain our ninth state, we travel from down south back up east to New Hampshire. From the furthest limits of the American colonies, our flag gave hope to all people that freedom would never die. The 10th strike represents the cautious colony that delayed the ratification of the Constitution until well that the Bill of Rights would be a part of that guarantee of liberty. Only then did Virginia, the oldest of the colonies and often referred to as the mother state, ratify the Constitution. On July 26, 1788, New York became the 11th state. She truly symbolizes hope because it is here that most of our immigrant citizens first saw the shores of their new country as they entered New York Harbor. And all gained new hope from the Statue of Liberty standing at the open door to welcome them. On November 21st, 1789, North Carolina ratified the Constitution and joined her neighbors in the new Union. And you see her stripe now being placed in our newly completed flag. Finally, in 1790, proud little Rhode Island took her place in the Union. And we placed the 13th stripe at the top of our flag for her. Whether you begin at the bottom or the top of the flag, the first stripe is always red. Perhaps this means that hope, the purity of the white, and the reverence and the loyalty of the blue are held steadfast. Securely bound by our valor, zeal, and fervency represented by the red. As a nation, we have these qualities, and we will, whenever necessary, use them to protect our American way of life. With all the stripes now in place, and the blue field ready to receive the stars, representing the original 13 colonies, let's see how our first flag was used. Delaware, December 7, 1787. Pennsylvania, December 12, 1787. New Jersey, December 18, 1787. Georgia, January 2, 1788. Connecticut, January 9, 1788. Massachusetts, February 6, 1788. Maryland, April 28, 1788. South Carolina, May 23rd, 1788. New Hampshire, June 21st, 1788. Virginia, June 26th, 1788. New York, July 26th, 1788. North Carolina, November 21st, 1789. Rhode Island, May Confederate flag. It took the colonies nearly 2 years to ratify the Constitution, but we must remember that the lines of communication were much slower than now. In those days, it took a letter 4 days to go from Washington to New York. The Postal Service tells us that today it can be delivered in less than 4 hours. 29 months were required to appoint 13 colonies with the terms of the Constitution and obtain their ratification. With modern means of communication, this could have been accomplished in a few days or a few weeks at most. Now the original colonies have been moved to a new field, in a pattern we are more familiar with today. Let's listen to the roll call of the remaining 37 states and their stars are placed in the blue field. Vermont, 1791. Kentucky, 1792. Tennessee, 1796. Ohio, 1803. Louisiana, 1820. Indiana, 1860. Mississippi, 1870. Illinois, 1818. Alabama, 1819. Maine, 1820. Missouri, 1821. Arkansas, 1836. Michigan, 1836. Florida, 1845. Texas, 1845.
Thank you. This concludes the flag program. We do have a few minutes for questions and answers, but I have one for you. Last year, during the election, Puerto Rico voted to become the 51st state of the United States. How would that change this pattern on this flag? Can you figure out how to put 51 stars in that field of blue? Think about that today. We're open to point out any questions that you have.
I'd like to have all the teachers come forward. We have some stuff for you to pass out to the children today.